garden. So I'll just quickly show you the table of contents here. There's 23 chapters, and I really didn't expect to write so much or so long, but the photos kind of wanted me to write about that stuff.
Do more.
Yes, do more. So there's a bit of background on how we ended up at Port Stephens, and then the chapters 4 to 6 do cover the main suburbs that we hang around, Shirley, Nelson and Fingal.
Mm.
So after that, chapters 7 to really 14, so 7 chapters, just puts all the other wonderful hamlets, really, they are wonderful seaside villages around Port Stephens. What was a revelation for me was going up to the northern part. So you'll see that, or you'll read about that in chapter 14, about the 5 towns, Bundaberg, Carrington, North Armco, Pindaberg, Tarley, just because historically they were the towns established there first, but they never really grew or expanded. The southern side did. And after that, I talked about chapter 16, which was Tomaru Coastal Walk, and I wasn't expecting that this year to open. They kept talking and talking about it. Remember how they talked and talked about it before COVID?
It was done in pieces. It was like
it was done in pieces. Yeah, I mean, I still remember going through Fingal Bay and remember how the helicopters would dropping
the soils,
dropping the soils just to make sure that they could clear the track and. So that was a bit of fun. So actually that chapter was pretty pretty funky as well to write about, just because it is a wonderful, wonderful walk. And, you know.
Yeah, it's worth doing.
It is definitely worth doing, especially during winter. I reckon wintertime is good for that.
But you do need to give yourself time.
Yes. I mean, the national parks has said 2 days is maximum for that, but I reckon 3 days easily. It's just basically trying to make sure you've got accommodation at the end of each day. But it reminds me a bit of, you know, the Camino, or the Camino de Santiago, or, you know, the movie The Way there. Except here we don't have the established hostels at the end of each day's journey.
Or Roman.
Yes.
The dude with the, you know, he had his hostel and he became, yes. He kind of was a.
Yeah, we really don't. We don't have that.
Weird, unusual
we
guy.
We don't have that. And after that, I think I talked about some other day trips, especially if you come by car to Port Stephens. I looked at all the little towns on the hinterland around Upper Hunter, down to really the Central Coast and Lake Macquarie, because. When you're driving from Sydney, you will also pass some wonderful, extraordinary, beautiful places on the coast. So I talked about that because, you know, personally, we would take a detour. So as I said, this is a very personal guide because it is really first-hand experience for us going up and down
the motorway. A lot of places got lost.
Yeah, and I think it's wonderful getting lost up, you know, Wollumbi and.
Yep.
So, and look, I hope that if say you're new to Port Stephens, that the instructions there on how to get here are, you know, clear enough, and I've included as much detail as I can, but, because it can be easily reached by public transport, you know.
Training it or busing?
Train and bus journey to Port Stephens is pretty de rigueur. So if you don't have a private transport, you can definitely public transport it. I still remember my backpacker days, so I know logistically how important it is to be able to use public transport because if you're a backpacker and you want to see the world, you want to, you know, you're on a budget and you want to spend your money not on... less on the travel time, but more on being able to enjoy the experiences an area has to offer. So I think if you want to do public transport, I think you can easily do it for less than, I don't know, $30, I reckon.
Central Station
to Newcastle, then from Newcastle take a bus. But, yeah, use the Opal card because we do have, despite the cuts to public transport, we do have a pretty good public transport system here.
Mm.
So, and some month-by-month activities and a bucket list guide. Oh, and I was thinking about chapter 22 while walking along a beach. I thought, you know, what are the best beaches for what aspect? Because that's what we do when we're up there. We tend to beach hop, don't we? If you get,
Different beaches depending on what we feel like doing.
yeah, and and that makes us really sound spoiled, but it's true because if Shoal Bay Beach is too crowded, we go down to Fingal, and if Fingal's too crowded, we go down to Box. And even if,
Float away, duchies, all
oh yeah,
those.
although Dutchies does tend to get busy, yeah. But yeah, if it's windy, we go out west to Dutchies, don't we? Yeah. So any last questions or comments about this book? Because Mr. Martin has been watching me beaver away on this,
No,
and
not really. It's pretty much a case of pick it up, have a look at it, and see what you think, really. I mean, it's sort of a, I guess, a travel guide with a little bit of a personal touch. So, eh.
And I think I've been honest about a lot of things in this book.
True,
So
true.
you're getting everything, the good, the bad, and the very much the ugly bits of, I suppose, living up there as well. Although it's quite relative. I mean, you know, there's always, you know, hell in paradise, I think.
Oh, it's going to happen anyway.
Yeah. But yeah, so this is the book, and I'm so glad I've managed to finish it just in time. And I hope you enjoy the photos,
Pretty
really.
much.
If
Just in time for Christmas and summer.
Exactly. Summer at Port Stephens.
Yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of, we should think about our summer plans. Anyway,
Iris.
all right. Okay, enjoy. And yes, this will be forthcoming soon and available to be bought.
Done.
Okay,
Enjoy.
bye.
See yous.
Bye.